pretty.
I need to remind myself, you do just need a day of rest.
He's kind of lost his mind.
I've just arrived in, where am I? Vienna. So hi, welcome to the Vienna vlog. Woo! Before this, I was in Budapest. So if you haven't seen that video, go check it out. I just arrived today. I got here at like 4. I had a nap because I was pretty tired from Budapest. It's definitely no rest in Budapest. I'm actually running late, so I have to leave. I'm meeting a friend, but I just wanted to quickly show you my room because I forgot that I treated myself to a private room in Vienna. So I got here and I was like, oh my God, I've got an ensuite, which is amazing. And it also feels like a hotel. So I'll quickly show you a room tour. This is my room, which is lovely. Got a little courtyard up back. So two beds, and then I've got a nice little shower. I'm about to turn that off. Bathroom, all you need. And yeah, I'm gonna now head out for some dinner. So maybe catch a rooftop bar. We'll just have to suss it out. But let's go. And Arnold. Hi. He's back. Ooh. Hi, Connor. Hi. Welcome back to the vlogs. We're checking out my rooftop. Jesus, it's bright
it's
up here.
It's a bit sunny out,
like. It's really nice.
I feel like outdoor.
Whoa, look at it, look at all this. Nice. This is awesome, hey? We'll have to come up here tonight. Getting in line for a cake, the Vienna cake with apricot and chocolate.
Yeah, a little bit of chocolate.
And a coffee, because I think we need this. We've just started this walking tour. It's like a 90-minute walk and we've already stopped at like 6 minutes. Well, it actually said on the walking tour, stop for a piece of cake. So
we're just doing what we're told.
We're literally just doing what we're told. About 6:30 now because we went to the palace, which by the way, I highly recommend the palace. It liked the gardens. We did like the little hike up with the viewpoint of the whole city. It was beautiful, loved it. The only thing is the dust and the garden. I literally am very highly allergic to dust and to pollen. So after that, I was not a happy girly. I was very sniffly. My eyes were watery and itchy and whatever. So the rest of the day I've been which is just not a vibe. So I'm hoping a shower and getting all the dust off is gonna help. Yeah, just chill here for a little bit tonight. Some of the boys will meet me here. My hostel's like having DJ play, so that'll be cool. You just never know with these things. Like sometimes they're a vibe and sometimes they're really sad. So we'll see if it's a vibe. But either way, like I just showed you this morning, but there's a rooftop. And so to go out there on the rooftop, see the sunset, have a drink, and then come down, see if there's a vibe, suss out whether we want to go out or not. I'll be honest, Budapest really like destroyed me. So just want to play low key, but Connor is 23 and just like, I don't know how he does it, but essentially I just went really, really hard in Budapest. We were like out every single night, and the earliest I came home was 1, the latest I came home was 5 a.m. So I'm just exhausted, I'm not gonna lie. And this private room is making me wanna have chilled vibes. Anyway, bye.
I only left instant at 25 to 4.
Love the
Yeah.
There's a church and it's freezing. So I'm going back inside. It's way too cold. I don't have a proper cardigan. What's happening over here? Yeah.
So you're originally from Luxembourg.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Everyone else that in your group was from Salzburg.
Yeah, but not like one dude was from Luxembourg as well.
And you're from Luxembourg, yeah. Okay. But how long have you been living in Vienna?
Well, I live nearly 2 years now.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm studying.
So you're kind of local now.
Yeah, true.
You're getting there.
I woke up very under the weather, like a sore throat, getting a little cough. I think it came from Budapest, if I'm honest. I also had been woken up like quite early in the morning because Connor had lost his phone. So this morning we've just been spending time like trying to find his phone, trying to contact people he was with last night to see if they remember where he was. And like what the venue was called last night. Anyway, so we've been doing like essentially admin. To be honest, I was feeling quite guilty about it. I was like, oh, I'm in Vienna, like, oh, I need to remind myself I'm traveling for 3 months, and sometimes there's just gonna be days where you don't wanna do anything extreme. You do just need a day of rest. It's gonna be another busy day tomorrow. So I'm thinking, just give yourself today to rest, like do all your admin, like all my washing is now clean. I need to like pack it away. Do you know what I mean? Like just one of those admin days. It's not gonna be very interesting. And then yeah, tomorrow I'm waking up early to do a really nice day. So that's my update. Good morning. What are you doing with all of your stuff? It's avoiding this, right? You pack your own food. Yeah, why pay when you can get on the cheap? We have to go to the Apple store today because Connor lost his phone. Anyway, he doesn't want to talk about it. Morning. We're starting to live with a see-through back. We're off to see stuff today. We're going to go to a really nice coffee place today. So we're excited about that.
It's very bougie.
After that, we're right by the museum. So I want to do the opera house. We have like a tour at 12 o'clock. Essentially what happened was I was looking at going to the opera, but it was 1 5-hour long and also 2 quite expensive. So what we were thinking is instead of doing that, I want to do the tour of the opera house because obviously it's like super famous and classic. Do the tour of it for only like 12 quid. And then I'm going to go see like a classic Mozart and Strauss show with hope for the best of those composers in a concert. So I'm hoping that we at least see some opera with that, the best arias or something, without having to sit through like 5 hours of opera. Oh.
This was definitely the best coffee I've had in Europe so far. The Vienna coffee is amazing. So good.
Try to imagine the singers back inside the stage. Depending on where they are, they must apply more or less energy to the voice. When the sound wave for the voice reaches the stage's mouth, it has enough energy, and the volume that comes from the orchestra pit is not going to be above the volume of the voice. Believe it or not, this is due to the vast emptiness of the stage. A huge portion of the sound wave from the voice is going to get lost before reaching the stage's mouth.
just arrived at venue that I'm going to watch classical musicals tonight. It looks like there's like a wedding or function or something. But yeah, I'm really excited to go see it. It's essentially a classical evening with arias. It's got Mozart, it's got Strauss, it's got, I think, ballet as well. Essentially 2 hours of a little bit of everything. Yeah, I'm just in the park now. It's such a nice evening. I'm gonna watch the show and then I leave really early tomorrow morning for Prague. So what did I think of Vienna? I personally think that Vienna is so beautiful. It's such a beautiful place to come if you also just want to wander and like take in so much amazing art. What else would I say? The amazing coffee and food generally reminded me of Paris and like the same sort of experience with like the amount of beauty just in every single crevice. Like I was walking in the museum today and literally every single corner I was like, oh my god, a chandelier, I want to take a picture. Or like, look at this beautiful, amazing wall. So yeah, the beauty here is amazing. And I also really liked the palace, like it, very wholesome activities essentially. I had a private room, I saw my friend Arnold. It was a really nice trip overall. So I'm excited to finish it off with some classical music because that's all what it's all about. And yeah. Last night the show was amazing. I think it was great to get like a little bit of everything because I got to hear like very famous pieces that I did recognize, but it was just nice to know that these had originated in Vienna. I'm currently walking to the station now and heading to Prague. So if you've come this far, thank you so much for watching, and on to the next. I'm heading to Prague. Yeah, catch me there. All right, bye.